away. Boys in session.
Yeah, you already probably or what? Is this all right?
All these great fighters that are in the series, and if you win the series, it's like, yeah, that's what's up. You know? battleground in the winter. And I would like to add that to my repertoire and a little action. So.
Thank you. Thank you, Jason. Right. PCS Live.
Ben from my line. For anyone who wants to answer this question,
sure,
in your amateur pursuits of trying to become a pro MMA fighter, has ever fought on the death of abortion, war on abortion?
First time ever, Dave.
First time ever. How's it feel?
Let's go right out now.
Well, that's right. You know what, dude? None of these guys are fighting tonight. This is awesome.
He is.
Oh, you are, really?
He is.
Oh, you should be. Go right ahead, man. You answer that
one. First time ever.
Yes, I do know that. First time.
Yeah.
The massive game deal. Actually, you're more than a statement. It's a big deal.
I mean, it's a big deal. I don't even think the UFC is about that.
That would be a negative. This might be the first time in all of MMA that anybody's fighting that well.
Been on them live, baby.
KLP, baby.
First time ever. Or not. That's just fine. I want to go right on down the line here for everybody that can take the time to show up. Give you guys a chance to address the press and the crowd. Tell us a prediction or how you feel going into this final on August 14th. Whatever you want to say, it's your turn. So we'll start with Dougie Whitener.
I'd just like to thank everybody for coming out to support us. So come out to the show. Judge, we gonna go to war with everybody. It's, you know, it's been a long time coming. We grew up wrestling with each other. We know we can wrestle on it. It's kind of fights and forms. They made the best man win and come out better friends and families. Somebody's gonna be evil, but come out like this.
Alright, thank you again, Dougie Whitener. We'll be facing Lee Sears, but in the middleweight final. One of these belts is going home with 22, and I'm going to move right to you, Lee, since he got to go. You guys are the only two that are competing against each other on August 14th. Why don't you rebut whatever you'd like to say? You can predict what you want to see. Tell everybody how it feels to have made it through to the finals or anything.
I'm just saying, like, well, I mean, that's very boring. We're all wrestling.
Woo-hoo!
Going out to all of us.
Absolutely. And Dougie's opponent, Lee Sears, none of these guys will be getting out on August 14th at the Berlin Raceway. Battle for Berlin Belt Finals. Herman Heppelhoff, your featherweight finalists. Go ahead and address the crowd, talk about predictions, anything you want.
Well, I'm kind of mad Ryan's not here. I can't talk about smack. But no, thank you guys for coming out. Everybody's here at the show. It's just going to be another one. He's just another person to win. We'll just see another first round finish. He's pretty good. He's pretty athletic. He does a lot of spinning stuff. But
so once he's going to spin and knock you down,
he's going to be like a top. So, you know, once he gets taken down, he's going to be like a fish out of water. Top.
Chet Kidder, light heavyweight finalist, taking on Phil Wilson. Then address the crowd, whatever you like. About prediction, how many deals do you need for that belt?
Well, thanks for everyone who came out. We enjoyed the fights tonight. And I'm actually looking forward to someone who actually has a legit gym and actually trains instead of people who just train in the basement. No offense to anyone who does, but. But I look forward to a good competition.
No love for an independent, huh?
Well, that's kind of funny.
And again, Jed Gitter at a light heavyweight. And again, Sean Rosenkrantz, main event, going for a bantamweight Berlin belt. What would you like to say to this crowd this afternoon? And what is the prediction for what you think is going to happen on August 14th?
Crowd's going to be
prediction, I don't know, because it's a fight. You never know what's going to happen. Anything can happen inside the cage. As far as the battle goes, I know it's going to be a hell of a battle. It's going to be the best fight of the night, guarantee it. Brandon Evans, very humble guy. One of the humblest fighters I've ever met. You know, just hands down one of the coolest dudes ever. And I know we're going to put on a show, and I hope everyone enjoys it. I know it's not going to go to the judges.
Well, the gentleman after the cage door opens, and the killer is closed. Again, Sean Rosenkrantz, your main event, taking place in the back layer. Moving down the dais, we have Cody Wiseman, a super flyweight finalist at 130 pounds, taking on Ben.
Nice.
Let's get that wrong. Let's change this
nice.
All right, Cody, any predictions for what we're going to see in that super flyweight contest?
It's going to be a war, you know. I'm going to go out and show up on the scene, you know. And I'm going to take the battle. There's a lot of people without me, you know.
Again, second fight of the night in the super flyweight division, Cody Wiseman going up against Ben Nias. And kicking off the night at the very end, at the far end of the table, flyweight's going to be the first fight of the night, taking on Mike Myers, Mr. Mike Dunbar. What can we expect for you guys kicking off the evening?
It's going to be exciting. Everybody keeps talking about these belts like they're something, but everybody from Asperia has enough accolades, they don't need it anymore. None of us want to stay here. We're all moving forward. I mean, they're going to be good fights. We're all ready.
And then at 6:30, you'll wrap this press conference up with pictures. Anybody wants to feel free to go up and address these gentlemen for a few minutes, get some pictures for whatever, or more personal questions for any of the press, feel free to do so. Oh yeah, get that microphone warmed up so everybody can laugh.